Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We begin with Allah's blessed name. We praise Him and we glorify Him as He ought to be praised and glorified. And we pray for peace and for blessings on all His noble messengers, and in particular on the last of them all, the Blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, as we greet you from Rawalpindi in Pakistan on this the 22nd day of the month, the blessed month of Ramadan, with Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and Ramadan Kareem. And anybody who knows me would know that I have much more preference for Rawalpindi than for Islamabad. It is the 22nd day of Ramadan in Pakistan, but it will not be the 22nd day for all the rest of you. Why? It is Allah's wisdom at work, and your wisdom is not greater than His wisdom, that He has given us a system of time in which the moon is centrally located. How many times must I repeat it? Lunar time. And He's given us this system of time in which the moon is centrally located. Why? لِتَعْلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ, that you might count the years and you might be able to compute time, the passage of time. And in that system of time which Allah has given, which we call sacred time, lunar time, there is the possibility that a month can have 29 days or it can have 30 days. And so it is not a precise system of time, precise, which can be universally applicable, a one universal system of time for all of mankind. No, you cannot have that. And the month begins when you see the moon in the sky above your head. And we will not all see the moon at the same time. So you don't need more than an elementary school education to understand that you will not have the beginning of Ramadan for everybody on the same day. And you will not have Eid for everybody on the same day. And you do not have more wisdom than the Lord God. I've explained in the past why Allah has given us this system of time in order to block Dajjal, who wants to establish a universal global society with one universal system of time. And he's succeeding because we no longer follow the sacred time. We no longer follow lunar time. We don't follow solar time. We're following Dajjal's secular time, in which a month can have 28 days. And a month can have 31 days. And so today is the 22nd day of Ramadan here in Pindi, in Pakistan. Pindi is a short for Rawalpindi. And tonight, therefore, will be the 23rd night, and therefore one of the odd nights of Ramadan. And we all know that Allah sent down the Quran in Ramadan, أَنْزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. He sent it down in Ramadan, and He sent it down on the night of Qadr, in Ramadan. And that night, He says, is so powerful, so important, it is such a grand night that it is better than 1,000 months. لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. We've dealt with this in a previous video. And we have offered our view, and I can be wrong. Remember that when I offer a view, Imran can be wrong. Only Allah can confirm. So do not accept my views uncritically. I have said that I believe, based upon the place where Suratul Qadr is located in the Quran, on that basis, I believe that the night of Qadr is located on the 29th day of the month, the night that everybody forgets. Finish, you close your shop and you go on shopping on the 29th. On the 29th, everybody is shopping, and that's the night I believe is the 29th, is Laylatul Qadr. But I should have mentioned, and that's why I'm doing this video, that our Prophet said, he said, look for Laylatul Qadr on the odd nights. No one must change that, including me. So not because I believe it's the 29th night would I stop looking for it on the 21st, on the 23rd, on the 25th, and on the 27th. We must continue looking for Laylatul Qadr on all of the odd nights. I have only voiced my view concerning the 29th because of this obsession with the 27th night. All the bright lights, everything, all the celebration on the 27th. And I believe you've been taken for a ride. So I'm doing this video just to remind you and to remind myself. Tonight in Pakistan will be the 23rd night. So tonight you must also raise your hands and make dua. This is the night for dua most of all, because the angels are coming down and Jibreel alayhi salam is coming down min kulli amra, to perform any task that Allah assigns to them. So if you have to ask, ask on this night. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might accept our fast of Ramadan and accept the Salatul Taraweeh and accept the Sadaqat and Zakat that we pay, and accept our Tilawatul Quran, our Qiraatul Quran in blessed Ramadan, that you might complete the recitation of the Quran from cover to cover in this blessed month, because this is the Sunnah of Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, and this is the Sunnah of Allah. Thank you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.